Welcome back, baseball fans. Summer 69-72 carryover league. We are back in the second round of the postseason tournament in the National League with a series between the Astros and the Pirates. Let's go take a look at the stakes in this series here. And here we are, five-game eliminations. There are eight teams trying to stay alive for four teams fighting for two playoff spots. We've already had Philadelphia knock off Arizona, and now the stakes are much harder for the Pirates than they were in the last series. Houston's playing Pittsburgh. Houston's two over, Pittsburgh's three under, which means Pittsburgh needs to win four out of five games, or their season would finally be over, as we have just been really disappointed with this team throughout regular season, tournament, etc. They've just not performed at all this year. The stats will back that up when we get to those later. So what happened? What's happened thus far? Series starts in Pittsburgh because, oddly enough, they're in second place in their division. The Astros are in third in theirs, so Pittsburgh gets home field. All they have to do is win a couple at home, win one of two in Houston, and win the fifth game back at home to win this four out of five. That would be the nice formula to make Pittsburgh fans happy. What happened in game one? Well, worked out pretty good. Game one with Steve Blass and Larry Durker, the aces of each staff. Sloppy baseball, an error scores a run in the first. Pirates get another run with a single, another run here. Two runs and an error in the fifth. Ball ultimately, Steve Blass is left alone to get a complete game win. Probably his best start of the year. He's had a rough year, but he gets a complete game. 3-2 victory. Larry Durker got injured in this game, so he only pitched seven innings. Things are going well for the Pirates to start out. So what happens in game two? Well, they lose. Well, Denny Lemaster, the all-star Houston pitcher, does throw a complete game, gives up three runs. Bob Veal, fortunately, got into the seventh inning. He'd given up a lot of base runners up to then. He came out. Pirate relievers. The hits were off the Houston card. Houston got all these singles off their own cards. Martinez, Edwards, Morgan, Mankey, and Wynn. So there's not a lot you can do about it when the one team is getting hits on their own cards, and that's what happened. Pirates attempted to rally. Denny Lemaster was left in this game after allowing two runs in the seventh because of the leaky Astro bullpen in their two previous series. But this time, he gets six of the next seven hitters out. And with the tying run at second and two outs in the bottom of the ninth, he gets Roberto Pena to sky to center. And just like that, Pirates get that loss that they were trying to avoid at home. And now we can finally say the next time the Pirates lose a baseball game, their season is over. I mean it this time. I mean it. This is a World Series favorite team. Winners of the 1971 World Series, the best record in baseball in 1972. In an unprecedented slump this year, it has not been pretty at all. So we have game three, but now we are in the dome. And the Pirates have to win two games in the dome and then come back home and win that one as well. Pitching today for the Pirates, their number three starter, Bob Moose. Moose is on the loose. And for the Astros, Joe Niekro, the number three starter, a very good Houston pitching staff. Let's get going. Matty Alou leads it off for the Pirates. 2-6, base hit. Minus one arm catcher, Alou is going to take off. They got nothing to lose at this point in their season. He gets the stolen base, and the T rating for John Edwards is 1-2-11, rolls a 13. Runner at second, Richie Hebner, an all-star, 3-6, skies to center. Roberto Clemente, 58, skies to right. And Willie Stargell, in a horrendous slump, was hitting 176. That's not a misprint. Hitting 176 in August, coming into this series, he's had hits in the first two games, showing signs of digging out of it. The pitch to Willie, 49 off Niekro, is a bouncer to short. This is Dennis Mankey. He's a three at shortstop. and he makes the play. Joe Morgan leading off for the Astros, 2-4, pitcher. Dennis Mankey, 2-11, grounds to short. Marty Martinez, 1-7, is a single. And with two outs, the Toy Cannon, 39, is a walk. Two on, two outs for the All-Star of the Astros. Let's take a look at him. Cesar Cedeno had a magnificent year with his 1972 card, arguably Cesar's best year. 1-3.88, double-A stealer, 22 homers, 320 average, 39 doubles, 8 triples. What more do you want out of the guy, huh? Two on, two outs. The pitch to Cesar, 2-8, is a grounder to short. Top of two, Bob Robertson, 49, grounds to short, again, out. Rennie Stennett, 1-8, base hit. Al Oliver, 1-2, pops to second. Manny Sanguian, 2-11, pops to short. Bottom of two, Jose Cruz, 2-5, grounds to first. Bob Watson, 2-2, grounds to the pitcher. Johnny Edwards, grounds to second. So, Moose and Nikro are up to it. Gene Alley in the third, 2-8, pops to second base. Matty Alou, 46, is a base hit. Going to try another stolen base attempt, and this time it goes Allrey. Out. Two outs for Richie Hebner. 56 is a base hit. Boy, that missed stolen base was rather unfortunate. Roberto Clemente having a great year. Run at first, two outs here in the third inning. 2-8, grounder to short. And the Pirates come up empty again. Bottom of the third, it's Norm Miller with the weather. Chance of rain, ball four on 3-6. I mean, aren't all weathermen named Norm Miller? I mean, sounds like a weatherman's name, I guess. Joe Morgan, 47, is a K. Dennis Mankey, 58, is a K. The Moose, dealing. Marty Martinez, 1-7, is a base hit in the left field. Miller will hold. He will not get, make the third out at third base. Toy Cannon with 2-1 and 2 outs, 4-4 off the Moose card is second X. But this is Stennett. No glove this year, and it's rookie year. 4-E-41, and he kicks the ball, but a run will not score. He smothered it. Bases are loaded. Two outs for Cedeno. 67, short X off the Moose card. This is Alley. He's a 2-E-24 at short, and he makes the play. Astros do not capitalize on that. Fourth inning for Pop Stargell. 2-9 is a strikeout. We are denting the 2-9. Let's look at Stargell's card. This card is ridiculous. And there's no reason this guy should be hitting 176 this year. I've rolled 2-9 a bazillion times. If he would have hit just a little bit less than what he hit, they might have given him the 210 card. He would have had homers on 210, 2-9, 2-8, and 3-7. And he'd probably be leading the league in home runs right now. But that's not the case here as he strikes out. Bob Robertson, 59, second. Rennie Stennett, 46, base hit. 2-for-2 for Rennie. And Al Oliver, 38. That's going to be a single to right field. Stennett will not make the final out of the third. And it's Manny Sanguian with two on and two outs. The pitch to Manny is a pop to third base. Teams are wasting base runners here. Bottom of the fourth. Joe Cruz, 37's a walk. Bob Watson, 110 is a K. John Edwards, 2-4 is a 1, 2-6, 2-3, double play. Moose and Nikro in a doozy here. Both teams have sent the same number of runners to the plate, hitters to the plate here. Top of five, Gene Alley, 42, skies the center. Matty Alou is 2-for-2. 67 is a pop to second, and with two outs, Hebner, 47, single 1-6, rolls to six, so he's on for Roberto Clemente, with a man on and two outs in the fifth inning. The pitch to Roberto, 39, is strike three. Scoreless in the dome. Let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
All right, doing a little kind of a little chamomile turmeric ginger thing going here. Kind of gets the, really gets the juices flowing here. Bottom of the fifth, scoreless. Norm Miller, 45 for Norm. Skies to center field. Joe Morgan, 212, lines out. Dennis Mankey, 68 is a walk. Marty Martinez, 411, first X, but Oliver's pretty good. He's a 2E14 at first. He makes the play. Scoreless in the sixth inning. Pops, Stargell, 34. You saw the card earlier. There's a homer on 3-5. He rolled 3-4. That's a strikeout. That's this whole year has been that. Bob Robertson, 39, walks. Rennie Stennett, 48, second X. This is Joe Morgan. He's a 3 at second base. Need a nice play here, Joe. 3E20. You get a ground ball C. Cannot turn two. We have a runner at second with two outs for Al Oliver. And 38, Oliver's going to get a single to right field. Bob Robertson is your runner. A 10, 11, and 12 cannot challenge the Joe Cruz arm. He will hold at third. First and third, two outs. Manny Sanguian. Here's the pitch to Manny. 270 comes through. Let's take a look at Sanguian's card. Manny bats eighth against right-handed pitching. He hit 325 in 1970. That's how great this Pirate team is. I'll just read the averages really quickly. 331, 301, 352, 295 with 48 bombs, 287 with 27 bombs, 353, 285. And Manny Sanguian's 325 batting eighth because he's better against lefties than righties. But their 2-7 is a single to center field. And the Pirates are on the board. Congratulations, Pittsburgh. One's it. Oliver will not challenge the Cedeno arm and try and go to third. So it'll be Gene Alley with first and second and two outs. 35 for Gene is a walk. Didn't want to do that if you were Joe Niekro. Now you've got the 331 bat of Matty Alou. With the bases loaded and two outs in the sixth inning, he's 2-for-3 already. The pitch to Matty Alou. 65 off the Negro card is a sky to center field. So, a walk, two singles and a walk gives you one run. And that's the best the Pirates can do thus far. Can Moose make it last? Can he get 12 more outs? We'll see. Toy Cannon, bottom of the sixth. 3-6, let's take a look at the Toy Cannon. That did not last long. The Toy Cannon, his 1969 card. Wow. 33 homers, 148 walks. He only had 17 doubles. Weird. Ace dealer, 3 minus 1 arm, E6. Solo shot, we are tied at 1. Had to play left field because they had Cedeno playing center. And this team has Joe Morgan. Gosh. And Jose Cruz. They should have just kept this team together, man. How much fun would this have been, huh? Morgan, Wynn, Cedeno, and Jose Cruz for a decade? Instead of Morgan being on Cincinnati and Jim Wynn being on the Dodgers? That's a shame. Here's Cedeno. 49 strikes out. Jose Cruz. 65, triple, 1-14 off the Moose is a double. Runner at second, one out. Moose is a starter 7. They're going to leave him in there. They don't like the long men in their bullpen. The back end's fine. Runner at second with one out. Bob Watson, 5'11 is pitcher X, but Moose is an E34. And that's an error. Too many mistakes for the Pirates this year. Too much. Not enough scoring, too many mistakes. Runners on the corners, one out. I'm doing their obituary, and we're still in a 1-1 game. Runners on the corners, one out. Infield comes up for Johnny Edwards. The pitch to Johnny, 45. That'll be a sac fly, and that'll give the Astros a lead. And now the Pirates season is 9 outs away. This is like the longest obituary in baseball history. We got a runner at first with two outs in the sixth. It's Norm Miller. Single 1-19 is a base hit. Two on, two outs for Joe Morgan. 1-9, let's take a look at the Joe Morgan card. Yes, Houston Astro in 1970. Only at 268, but 102 walks and 55 strikeouts. This is just ridiculous. I don't know how you let this guy get away. Anyway, Morgan, double one of 13. That's a double. That'll pick up another run. Runners go to second and third, two outs. Dennis Mankey in a 3-1 game. Pitch to Dennis. 35 is a walk, and the bases are loaded and two outs for Marty Martinez. I have no idea what the Pirate life raft is here in this situation. What do? You don't leave him in, take him out. No clue with this team. No idea. Everything they do is wrong. And it's Marty Martinez. Let's take a look at the Marty Martinez card, folks. Yeah. 308 in 200 plate appearances in 1969. Play all over the place. Great utility player. You could bring a lefty in here, but that just seems kind of ridiculous. Moose is pretty good, actually, and he's not broken yet. So, they're going to stick with the Moose. In a 3-1 game, bases loaded, two outs, pretty much the season right here for the Pirates. The pitch to Marty Martinez. 59 off the Moose is a sky to left field. Moose gets out of it. It's a still ball game. 3-1 in the seventh for Joe Niekro, who has put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 men on base. We have seen repeatedly when I broadcast Houston games, the bullpen blow saves. Jim Ray blew saves against the Giants, blew saves against the Padres, as did Ron Cook and Ken Forsch and Dooley Womack, duly noted Womack. So we'll have Niekro continue into the seventh. If he puts a guy on, maybe we'll hook him. Here's Hebner. 37 for Hebner. Single one of 13 is a base hit. He'll pitch to Clemente in a 3-1 game. 1-7, Clemente, double one of four is a base hit. About to break. If you were thinking about bringing in a lefty to play Stargell, this would be the situation. So that's what they're going to do. They're pulling Niekro in a 3-1 game. He cannot lose. They'll go to their lefty here to face Stargell with two on and nobody out. Willie Stargell in the seventh. He could correct a lot of wrongs that have happened this year. He's 0 for 3 with two strikeouts. No idea what his batting average is right now. Maybe 185 or something. 2-1, nobody out in the seventh for Stargell. He can fix a lot of wrongs that have happened this year. The pitch to Stargell. 57 is ball four off of Cook, who's been kind of awful this year. And the bases are loaded. And frankly, they have no faith in Ron Cook. He's been getting blasted all year. However, against righties, he's not that bad. And Bob Robertson's better against righties. Stennett's better against righties than you have Al Oliver. So they're just going to let Cook pitch here. They're going to have the infield playback with the bases loaded, nobody out in a 3-1 game. This has the looks of like an 8-7 final. Anyway, 3-1 game, bases loaded, nobody out. They're playing back. The pitch to Bob Robertson. 59, short X. This is Dennis Mankey. He's not the greatest fielder. He's a 3E40 at short. 3E40. We'll look right here for the result. Oh, it's a single. That's what I'm talking about. These teams cannot finish games very well. Neither of them, really. Bases loaded. 3-1 game at Stennett. I think they're going to play... Let's see. They'll play the infield out. For Stennett. I don't think it's going to work, though. Here's the pitch to Stennett. 2-6. There's your single dot. We got a tie game. There's nobody out. 3-3. Guess the Pirates season isn't done yet. Al Oliver. Bases loaded. Nobody out. Bring the infield up. Why not? Let's see. So, 8 of the last 9 Pirates have reached in a 3-2 game or 3-3 game. The pitch to Al Oliver. 54 off of Cook is sky to center C. Too shallow for a sack fly. And that'll do it for this clown. Ron Cook is gone. And Manny Sanguin and Gene Alley are up with three righties on the bench. So I'm looking for a right-handed reliever the best right-handed reliever who can get righties out on the team? And the answer is Ken Forsh. Sure, why not? Ken Forsh will come trotting out of the Houston pen and will face Manny Sanguian, who knocked in the first Pirates run. It's a chance to knock in the lead-ahead run here. The lead-ahead? The go-ahead. That's it. The go-ahead run. Manny Sanguian, he has a lot of double plays in this card. They're going to bring it up anyway because you can still get a 6-2-3 double play. So Sanguian, the infield up here, and the base is loaded, one out. The pitch to Manny. 4-10 off of Forsh. Homer, 1-9, double, and that will be a double. And Stennett is not going to challenge the arm in center field. And it's 4-3, it's 5-3. Second and third, one out. They're going to bring it up for Gene Alley. 59, lines the second. And with two outs, it's Matty Alou. 55 is a K. Stretch time here in Houston, as once again they've Astro fans have watched their team blow another lead. We've been listening to the No Other LP by Gene Clark, 1974. There must be some misunderstanding. Great tune. And bottom of the seventh, the Moose is a starter seven. He worked his way through that long sixth inning. Now he has a two-run lead, and he's going to continue on. At this point, the Pirates can move to the back end of their bullpen if it gets dicey. So, leading off in the seventh will be the Toy Cannon. 4-11 off Moose is center X. This is Matty Alou, a 2-E-8 in center field. And that is a base hit. Wind can steal, but you don't want to get thrown out down two runs. And it's Cesar Cedeno, who's kind of quiet today. The pitch to Cesar. 2-12, sky's the center. Jose Cruz is the batter. The pitch to Jose. 53 off Moose. Left X. Star to the left. He's a pretty good fielder. He's a 3-E-4 in left field. A 3. And that's a single dot dot. Off the Stargell defense. Runners on the corners. One out for Bob Watson. Oh, my goodness. Whatever. We're going to hook the Moose. No clue at how to manage a Pirate team that constantly figures out a way to lose. Last inning, I let Moose pitch, and it worked out. He got out of it. I just don't think he can do it two innings in a row based on the Pirates' history. So let's go to one of their very capable relievers, Ramon Hernandez. Again, Ramon Hernandez, 5-0 with a 1.67 ERA in 1972, and Justy was 7-4 with a 1.92 ERA in 72. I have no idea why this team is three games under 500. They got pitching, starting pitching, the back end of the pitching, one of the best offenses in all of baseball, and every game's a struggle. So here's Ramon Hernandez in the seventh with runners on the corners and one out. It'll be Bob Watson. Let's take a look at Bob Watson. He's okay in 1970. He will get better soon. He's not quite the hitter we know him to become. They're going to play back with a two-run lead. Cruz is a C-stealer. He's not being held. The pitch to Bob Watson. 57 off Hernandez is a K. And with two outs, Sean Edwards is going to come out of the game. And it'll be Doug Rader. He's a monster. Take a look at Doug Rader's card. This is an interesting substitution because Marty Martinez can also catch. We're pinching with a catcher with a third baseman, so those two positions will swap. Simple substitution there. Playing back for Doug Rader. Two on and two outs. The pitch to Doug. 66 off Hernandez is a liner to short. Pirates are staying alive. Top of the eighth for Ken Forsh. It'll be Hebner. Hebner, 2-9, is a walk. And the good news, well, not good news, but anyway, Negro can't lose. It's Ron Cook and Forsh responsible for losing here. Roberto Clemente, 58. This guy's a center. Stargell, 69. Single on a 1. Lines out. And with two outs, it's Bob Robertson, 6'10", is a walk, two on, two outs for Rennie Stennett. Nothing to do here. 55, sky's the left. 5-3. Hernandez is still in there. There's a little bit of defense the Pirates can bring in. Bill Mazeroski is a good, solid second baseman. He will come in for Stennett. You also have Gene Elliott short, so your defense is pretty good all through the infield and outfield, really. Twos and threes everywhere. So, bottom of the eighth, Norm Miller against Ramon Hernandez? I don't think so. They're going to bring in Jose Martinez, the pinch hit, and BDH. Jose Martinez, bottom of the eighth. 54, sky's the center X. This is Matty Alou. He's a 2E8, and that's a double off Matty Alou. The tying run will be the leadoff hitter, Joe Morgan. The pitch to Joe, 65, second C. The runner goes to third. They are not bringing the infield up. They're going to leave it back, and the Astros will say, well, we'll take a run on a ground ball and then go for a one-run game in the ninth. Dennis Mankey with a runner at third and one out. The pitch, 211. He pops to short. And with two outs, Marty Martinez, who stranded three men in the sixth inning. Marty, 37, is a bouncer to short, and the inning's over. Ramon Hernandez delivers. We'll go to the ninth, and Forrest will finish this thing for the Astros. Al Oliver, 111, sky's the center. Sink in, 3-6. Homer, 1-10, fly ball to left, and he misses the home run. And with two outs, it's Gene Alley. 49 is a double, off the Forrest card. And with two outs, it's Matty Alou. 5-10, left C. Two-run game in the ninth. Dave Justy's warming. It's Wynn, Cedeno, Cruz, and then after that, they'll go to the right-hander. Ramon Hernandez is a relief three. Probably will not finish the inning, but he'll start it. So, the toy cannon leads off for the Astros in the ninth. 67 is a K. Cedeno, 68, is a pop to first. And with two outs, it's Jose Cruz, the lefty, against Ramon Hernandez. This is an eight-out save attempt for Ramon Hernandez, pushed into emergency relief pitching here. Probably won't be available for game four, if there is a game four, but it looks like there will be. Jose Cruz, the pitch. 2-6 is a roller to first, and the game's over. The Pirates did it. They rallied in the seventh inning to avoid elimination. Their best performance of the year. And the difference was relief pitching and clutch hitting. Astros left the bases loaded in the sixth. Pirates brought four runs in. And a lot of base runners were wasted early in this game. This is not good news for the Astros either. Even if they win this series, their overall win-loss record will not be very good, and they might get bounced in the very next series they play. Let's do the box here. Ron Cook came on here to face Stargell. And he basically gave up two hits, two runs, and a walk, and will take the loss. Forrest came on in, faced Sanguian, gave up a double. And then he got the next two guys out. A hit, two walks and a K, two hits, two walks and a K. And six innings for Negro. The runs in the seventh are charged in, so we gave up three runs. Total of 11 hits and three runs. Does not lose, though. It was all earned. Two walks, three strikeouts. Ramon Hernandez, nice gutsy save here. Came on in the seventh. That was the right move. Glad I can finally do something right for the Pirates. He faced Bob Watson. Gave up a hit and a K. A hit and two Ks. Boom. That's what the Pirates need. A hit and two Ks out of their one reliever. And they'll have Justy. They'll have Justy in a game four for help. Moose gets the win. He really pitched out of a lot of mistakes. 3-run sixth inning. But oddly enough, we're only going to give one of those runs earned. 5 walks and 4 strikeouts. 1019, 0109, 515, 39, 54, 56. Pirates put 20 men on base, scored just 5, but the Astros only put 14 men on base. So the teams are alternating games, which would be enough for the Astros, but you got to be kind of nervous if you're Houston. You've lost your last 2 series. At one time, this Astro team was 15-8 and in first place in the West. And since then, they're down just being a game over 500. And seeing their playoff hopes start to fade away a little bit here. Year to date, Astros are 18-17, hitting .273 with a .395 ERA. Larry Durker is 7-3 and Denny Lamaster is 6-0. They're 13-3. The rest of the staff is 5-14. And if you look at the back end of their pitching staff, Jim Ray is 0-4. Ron Cook 1-3. Ken Forrest has 2 losses. Dooley Womack has a loss. Just incredibly bad relief pitching. That's just ruined Houston's year to this point, and they're just a game over 500. Well, on the other hand, the Pirates, they're 2 games under 500, hitting .278 with a .375 ERA. I know you're all wondering, what is Stargell doing this year? He's 23 for 131. He's hitting .176 again, so he was hitting .176 to start the series and has maintained it. He's got 4 homers and 13 RBI. Manny Alou's having a pretty good year. Hitting .327, that's good. Clemente, 48 for 143. .336. Anyway, I will report the results of the rest of this series at the end of the video. We have played 565 games thus far this year. The league is hitting .259. With a .384 ERA. That's it tonight. I will continue this series between the Pirates and Astros, report the results later. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time. Well, sports fans, the Pirate season is over. Yes, not kidding this time. They lost. Finally, put a dagger in them. Get a silver bullet or some garlic or whatever. The Pirates are toast. In game 4, they had a 5-1 lead, a homer by Clemente, a 3-run homer by Manny Sanguian, and the idea was floated around. This team could run the table, but no. They stuck with Steve Blass, and oddly enough, the control problems that would hinder him later in his career. He walked 7 6 2/3. Those control problems popped up here in the 5th, 6th, and 7th innings. The Pirates ran with him because Ramon Hernandez had pitched 2 2/3 innings the day before. They couldn't find a bridge to Justy. They ran with Blass too long. The Astros rally took a 7-5 lead. And what's concerning for the Astros is Larry Durker threw a complete game because they refused to open the bullpen door. They were not going to lose another game with their bullpen. Which means that Larry Durker and Denny Lamaster have won 12 of the 18 games the Astros have won this year, and the bullpen's lost 14 games, something like that. The Astros, you know, they were 15-8 at one point. Since then, they've won 4, lost 9. First round of the tournament, they were 2-3. They're 2-2 in this round. They're going to limp into the third round of the tournament, possibly on the outside looking into that last playoff spot. Pretty lackluster series. Thanks for checking it out. We'll see you next time.